just so you can see, this is how we cut the door opening out. Or at least trim the door opening so that we can put the rubber seal on it. As you probably noticed by now, we're doing it on a car that we just put on the frame. And we're getting ready to do it. This side's getting ready to be cut. And I'll show you my assistant cutting it so you can see how he does it. Alright. He's going to attack it with his trusty 90 degree die grinder with a cutoff wheel on it. This is the most effective way that we use to do this. He's actually learning how to do this. Proper distance. Okay, so he's feeding it towards the, away from the body. This allows us to get a nice, smooth cut. There's a close-up so you can see what it is. You'll also notice he's cutting it in such a way that the debris is thrown away from him. And he's working at a speed that allows the blade to cut rather than pushing it through the fiberglass. There you go, there's a good shot of the fiberglass breaking free. Now, colors are a little fun. We're going to watch for a little bit. Watch how he does this corner. Notice, he turns it 90 degrees to his line, sets a short series of teeth, and he's going to go back later and cut the teeth out. This is how we make these curves. Until he reaches a flat section. And then he'll come back and he'll cut the teeth out. Eventually coming back to grind it out. Smooth. He gave the side that I just did. I'm going to walk around to the other side of the car. Bear in mind, this is a busy shop. We are actually in the process of building the car. Now, this is the side I just got done doing. You remember how he did his teeth? I did my teeth the same way. See, it still needs a little bit of finish. A little more finish. Here, let's zoom out for a second. And you can see I still have to sand a little bit more, but basically the shape is there. The only reason I stopped is because I wanted him to get some practice doing this. He's never done this before. Okay. It's a fairly simple process. I'm going to show you one other thing. Should take a good close look at that. Let's switch on to our zoom. Now, as you'll notice, I've actually sanded on the inside. But basically, giving myself a certain thickness to the door jamb flange. The reason I do that. When I put the door rubber on, it's going to be nice, smooth throughout. There you go. There goes another 2 teeth. This is how we get the clearance.